Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Labs lecture discussing the basics of analog input 3-wire 4 to 20 milliamp transmitters. These types of transmitters use a voltage or current input that is translated to the 4 to 20 milliamp output signal. The concepts introduced in this presentation will be described using a mix of discrete solutions and partially integrated solutions using TI's XTR products. In this video, we will derive the transfer function for a 3-wire transmitter and go through the design considerations for TI's XTR-111, XTR-300, and XTR-305, such as the compliance voltage and external component selection. In a previous video, we introduced the following characteristics of a 3-wire 4 to 20 milliamp transmitter. A 3-wire transmitter uses two transmission wires to connect the transmitter output to the load and the receiver's ground to the transmitter's ground. Typically, the third wire in this 3-wire transmitter connects the local supply to the device. But there are applications where the transmitter uses the same supply as the receiver. The supply current and signal current are in two separate loops. This allows the transmitter to interface with inputs that need to be ground referenced. Because the output signal doesn't include the current consumed powering the sensor and transmitter, the output can go down to 0 milliamps. This allows the designer to use the common 0 to 20 milliamps or 0 to 24 milliamp output spans as well. This slide will walk through the derivation of the transfer function for this standard 3-wire current output topology. First, negative feedback of the A1 amplifier sets V1 plus and V1 minus equal to each other. The input to the transmitter, VDAC, is tied to V1 plus, making V1 minus also equal to VDAC. The current through Rset is equal to VDAC over Rset. In a MOSFET, the drain current is equal to the source current, so the current through RA equals the current through Rset. The voltage at V2 plus equals the supply voltage minus the voltage drop across RA, which is RA times I1. To set the inputs of A2 equal, the RB resistor must therefore have the same voltage drop across it as RA. I3 therefore equals I1 multiplied by the ratio of RA over RB. Iout is then equal to I3 and can be defined by expanding I1 back to VDAC in Rset, as seen in the equation here. The TI-XTR 3-wire 4 to 20 milliamp transmitters are voltage input, current output transmitters. Shown here is the XTR-111. A 3-wire transmitter allows the input signal, VIN, to come from bridge sensors, digital to analog converters, or microcontrollers that are ground referenced. An internal I-set current is created from the input voltage divided by the external R-set resistor. A current mirror provides a gain, and the output current, IS, is transferred to the load through an output FET, Q1. The additional PNP transistor, Q2, provides the current limit protection for the XTR-111. The two transmission wires, shown here in red, connect the transmitter output to the load, and the load's ground to the transmitter's ground. The third wire in this 3-wire current transmitter connects the local supply to the device. The XTR-111, XTR-300, and XTR-305 use an Rset resistor to select the output span based on the voltage input as seen in the transfer function derivation. Because the Rset resistor divides the input voltage into Iset, the precision of both Rset and the VIN voltage needs to be considered. When building a discrete transmitter or using an XTR part, select a precise and low drift resistor for best performance because resistor drift directly translates to drift of the output current. Also take care to minimize the series resistance added to Rset in the circuit layout. The XTR-111 uses an external PNP transistor, Q2, as an external current limit protection circuit to avoid large current transients when the loop is closed or the load is connected to the current transmitter. All the transmitter output current flows through the external PFET transistor, Q1. With high supplies and currents exceeding 20 milliamps flowing through the loop, the designer needs to carefully consider the power and voltage rating of the PFET transistor. In most cases, the external transistor may require a heatsink. The XTR-111 supports a wide supply range up to 44 volts, and the datasheet provides recommendations for selecting the external PFET transistor. The XTR-111 delivers the precise output current to the IS pin. The voltage at this pin is normally 1.4 volts below the V supply. This output requires an external transistor that forms a cascode for the current output. The transistor must be rated for the maximum possible voltage on Vout and must dissipate the power generated by the current and the voltage across it. The gate drive, VG, can drive from close to the positive supply rail to 16 volts below the positive supply voltage. Most modern MOSFETs can accept a maximum VGS of 20 volts. A protection clamp at VG may be required for MOSFETs that have a VGS voltage rating below 16 volts. In this case, the XDR may pulse the VG voltage beyond the VGS rating of the MOSFET. Pulling the output disable pin high disables the gate drive and closes a switch connecting an internal 3 kΩ resistor from the V supply pin to the VG pin. This resistor discharges the gate of the external FET and closes the channel, which effectively disables the output. An external PFET transistor ensures high output resistance and a broad compliance voltage range that extends from 2 volts below the supply voltage to voltages well below ground. In a 3-wire transmitter, the compliance voltage is the minimum voltage that must be maintained between the supply input and the output terminal before the output current stops regulating properly. When the voltage drop due to the output current and load plus wire resistances reduces the VDS voltage across Q2 below the difference of the device's VGS and VTH voltage, the device can't remain in saturation and enters the linear ohmic region, reducing the output current. A larger load connected between I-out and ground will increase the voltage at the I-out pin and decrease the voltage across Q2. Ensure that the supply is greater than the maximum current times the maximum load plus the compliance voltage. The compliance voltage for the XDR devices is usually around 2 to 3 volts, depending on the part being used. In addition to the XDR-0111 mentioned in the previous examples, TI also has the XDR-300 and XDR-305 3-wire 4-20mA transmitters. The XDR-300 and XDR-305 have the same functionality with a few differences in datasheet specifications. As seen here, there is an Rset resistor that divides the input voltage into a current. Similar to the XDR-111, there is a current mirror with a gain of 10 that regulates the output current. The XDR-300 and 305 have current output and voltage output modes. Seen here is the current output mode of the XDR-300 and 305. Digital control pins M1 and M2 select between the modes. For current mode, M1 is set to high and M2 is set to low. The transfer function is given by 10 times Vin over Rset. The OPA driver can deliver more than plus or minus 24 milliamps within a wide output voltage range. The addition of the R offset resistor allows for a bidirectional output with a single-ended input. An open output condition or high impedance load that prevents the flow of the required current activates the load error flag, and the instrumentation amplifier, IA, can become overloaded and draw greater than 7 mA saturation current. In current output mode, the IA can be used as an independent monitoring channel, or a current, IIA, that is proportional to the voltage at the IA input can be routed to IA out, which can be used to monitor the load voltage. A resistor, RAA, converts this current into a voltage. This arrangement makes level shifting easy. The next slide will describe the voltage operation mode. The voltage operation mode of the XDR-300 and 305 utilizes the on-chip instrumentation amplifier of the XDR. The digital control pins M1 and M2 are both set to low. The feedback loop through the IA provides high impedance remote sensing of the voltage at the destination, compensating the resistance of a protection circuit, switches, wiring, and connector resistance. The output of the IA is a current that is proportional to the input voltage. The gain of this mode is set by the gain resistor of the IA, and the Rset resistor as seen in the transfer function shown here. Similar to the current output mode, the addition of the R offset resistor allows for a bidirectional output with a single-ended input. A 1/10 copy of the output current of the OPA can be monitored at the IMON pin. During an output short circuit or overcurrent condition, the XDR-300 and 305 output current is limited and the load error flag is activated. Applications not requiring the remote sense feature can use the OPA in standalone operation by setting M1 to high. In this case, the IA is available as a separate input channel. As mentioned in a previous video, multiple 3-wire transmitters can be used in parallel to transmit multiple signals coming from one multi-channel digital-to-analog converter. Shown here is a schematic from the TIPD-155 reference design, where two XDR-300s are used to transmit two voltage output signals from the DAC-8563. Unlike 2-wire transmitters, where the I-return pins float and need to be independent from each other, 3-wire transmitters can share their grounds with other 3-wire transmitters without any input isolation. The reference design is linked to this slide and offers a full design walkthrough including part selection, simulations, and design layout. Shown here is a table of TI's 3-wire XDR 4-20mA transmitters which are voltage input, current output transmitters. All of TI's three-wire XTRs have transfer functions that allow for a flexible range of voltage inputs and current outputs. As you can see, the XTR300 and 305 have the option to use a voltage output or current output. They also include error flags and digital input select pins to switch between the current and voltage output modes. That concludes our video discussing the basics of 3-wire transmitters. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of this video's content.